Hey guys, it's Shonda Hunt, and today I want to take a deeper look at some of the things we discussed in Chapter 2, Episode 1. In Chapter 2, Episode 1, we mentioned that nodes are small mathematical machines that read, process, and manipulate pixels. I think it is important to think of nodes in this sense, as well as to understand that each node is looking for specific information when it's attempting to process the pixels to give you the results that you want. Therefore, it is important to understand how you can manipulate your footage with the nodes, but also how you can manipulate your footage for the nodes to work in a way that you want. Nodes are tools, and for them to work properly, they have to be given the correct information. An example of this idea is when we use the high pass or any other filtering method before we do our tracking so that the tracking node has better information to grab from. This concept of adjusting the footage can also be used with most workflows, especially when you're keying. We also went over the write node. I do want to note a few more things. When you're working in a production environment, your write node will be customized for you and for your particular project, so you won't have to worry too much about the settings for this node. If your project is not set up for you and you do not have a write node, and you're asked to go ahead and adjust all of these settings, then it will be up to you to make sure all of these settings are correct. However, when you're learning and practicing different workflows in Nuke independently, you don't have to worry too much about adjusting all of these settings. What you will want to do is make sure your file path is named correctly and that you have the padding, the number padding that we mentioned earlier within your file name. So for now, let's run some tests. I'm going to simply run a test without any frame padding in between. And if you try to render a project with no frame padding, your project actually will not render. So it looks as if the render has finished. However, if we go to our folder, we'll see that we do not have anything in that folder. I showed you in the video two ways to pad your framing. So let's go ahead and use the hashtag method. Well, you can use as many hashtags as you need to. Even one is good enough. I use three or four when we're working, and that's because most projects are set at 1001. So they have four digits. So you would use four hashtag, one for each digit. And now I'll go ahead and try to render those same frames. And we'll see the render button pop up with the progress showing that it's actually rendering. And now if we go to that folder, we'll see that we actually have a render. So it's definitely important to add that frame padding within your file names when you're working independently and you're trying to render something out. We also talked about some of these image nodes. The ones that are most frequently used, aside from the read and write node, of course, are the constant and the checkerboard. The curve tool is also used, and the profile tool is very handy and useful when your comps are running slow. In the previous episode, I did go ahead and run that profile node. However, let's just run a clean one so that we can see some of the options that we have. I'll just choose a frame range. You can choose any frame range. You can just do one frame. One frame is usually good enough as well if you're just trying to check to see which nodes are taking up too much processing for your comp. So let's open the profile node. And you don't specifically need to adjust all of these, but for now, we'll run it just to show you what pops up. By default, this will be empty until you go ahead, run the node, and then information will populate here telling you which notes are heaviest. And this can help you to optimize your script. The other handy note which we discussed is most commonly used is a checkerboard. And that's most often used when you don't have the background yet for your green screen. You could go ahead and drop in the checkerboard so you can start checking your edges and check your mat so you can see how things are looking. And the constant note, which you can use for the IBK color instead of the IBK color node. You can also use the constant for a temporary backdrop, as well as when you're making some color correction adjustments and when you're building custom effects in Nuke. All right, guys, that's all for a deeper look from Chapter 2, Episode 1. I do want to mention again, if you have any questions or if you need any clarification regarding any of the things that I mentioned in my episodes, just be sure to leave a comment in the comment section with your questions, and I'll be sure to get back to you to answer.